Often, when I look at a monthly report, I see man hours per ton or labor cost per ton of product. But then, when there is a deviation, basically that number still doesn't tell me anything about the actual performance of the plant. So let's get into a better system to check overall labor efficiency. Welcome to my channel, where we discuss continuous improvement in an industrial setting. Now, if we check industrial costs, mainly we see materials, we see personnel cost, we see lots of other fixed cost. Yes, in your business there might be different costs as there are in mine, but let's take these as an example. Now, what do we see in the reporting? We of course want to know how they do versus budget. And the budget is a fixed number, but our production is not fixed. So one of the first things we do is we divide it by the total produced volume to get a grip of how we were doing based on the volume. And from a purely financial cost perspective, this is a very good way to check our numbers. But it doesn't really tell me a lot about the performance, the physical performance of our operations at the factory. Now, what do we do with materials? We usually compare them to the bill of material. Why? Because there is a big difference between different products. If there are different ingredients in a number of different products that we make in the same factory, months would be uncomparable if we don't take into account how much is ordered of the different products. And for some reason, we do not do this when comparing personnel costs. Now, man hours are actually quite similar in that they also can depend seriously on the product you produce. If you take, for instance, a product that you produce in a line where you need multiple operators to operate it, then the labor costs per ton of this product will be higher. Also, if the line is more or less efficient, it will cost you more or less time from the operators. And then, of course, there is also the part where maybe you have too many people walking around, and that is exactly what you would like to have your insights on. So I propose that instead of looking at the man hours per ton or the labor costs per ton, we start looking at it from an overall labor effectiveness perspective. For this, we start with a basic overall equipment effectiveness, an OEE, and we take from that one very important factor, and that is that we take only the open time. So any time that the factory is closed, there are no operators working on the line, we do not count it. But the basic good effective production versus open time ratio still remains. So now we take the open hours of your machinery, we multiply it by the number of operators required to run this machinery, and then we get the total needed hours for our production. Compare this to the actual paid labor hours, we've got a ratio. If you have a department or an accounting system where you have multiple lines, but the operator pool is registered as one unit, you should add the open times of each of those lines multiplied by the needed manning of each of those lines. This will give you a number of lost man hours, so to say. It will also give you a ratio of paid hours to needed hours. Now, this is the thing we are going to use in our reporting. But let's first break down why we have those lost hours. We will use a system quite similar to OEE breakdown, but then focused on man hours. And like with OEE, we will have a number of losses that we cannot readily reduce. For instance, breaks. We all need breaks during our work, and if we do not stop the line for this, we will need some extra personnel to relieve each other during these breaks. Then also you can think of non-production work. For instance, inspections. You really plan your personnel on something other than making product. This can be also trainings, meetings, other administrative tasks. Then we have somebody who's absent, sick leave, other reasons. If we still count these hours as paid, which most companies do, then of course we also have to declare them in our analysis. And the one that is not so often reported are the vacation hours. In the end, they are paid. Most companies I've seen do not count them in their total paid hours in the direct costs. So this depends also a bit on what your company is using as their standard accounting rules. Now, I talked about the ratio of actually paid hours to needed hours. And if we multiply this by the OEE percentage, we get the overall labor effectiveness. And these two, the OEE and the OLE, are very good performance indicators for your reporting. So to support your man hours per ton KPI, you can report simply the number of hours of manning loss, Or you can go for OEE combined with either the labor ratio or the overall labor effectiveness. And this will make for a much stronger reporting tool because you will see where the problem lies. If you have a bad OEE, but this month still had a good labor ratio, you know that you have to find your problems more in the machinery. Now, if you have an industry where the machine is not the bottleneck, and it's really much more about your workforce being able to finish their jobs, and they just use a bit of machinery when they go, then the whole OEE concept is not very useful for your industry. In this case, we calculate the overall labor efficiency in a different way, much more people-centered. But we'll discuss about that in another video. For now, I just want to leave you with the idea: report and deploy your OEE with your labor ratio combined as your overall labor effectiveness. I wish you the best of luck with your continuous improvement, and as always, enjoy the journey.